On this week's edition of District Directions, we will be joined by Mrs. Connie Blaney with the district update, Mr. Rex Suba with the pinpoints, and new to our show will be Dr. John Clinton as he discusses the fine arts programs of Norman. Stay tuned. Welcome back to another edition of District Directions. I'm your host, Amanda Patterson. To get us started today is Mrs. Connie Blaney, who is always an angel to keep us informed of the recent activities of the Board of Education. So without further ado, here she is with the district update.
Good evening. The Norman Public School Foundation Drive is underway. Monday, March 24th and Tuesday, March 25th were the kickoff for a direct mail drive. Patrons who have donated in the past and prospective donors will be receiving letters this week. Donations benefit the students in Norman by providing money for classroom grants. The foundation gives grants twice a year to teachers in the district. Grant money also provides staff development grants. We encourage everyone to support our foundation, which assists our educational programs. For information about how to donate, contact me at 366-5961 or any school foundation board member. On Friday, April 11th, employees in Norman Public Schools will participate in an afternoon in-service training, Dr. Nancy O'Brien, assistant superintendent, announced. There will be no school in the afternoon on this date. Lunches at regular prices will be offered to all students wishing to eat at school. This district will also provide bus transportation home for the eligible students. Dismissal for the in-service day for elementary students will be at 11:45 a.m. This includes morning kindergartners. Buses will run at 11:45 and daycare vans will pick up the students at 11:45. Kindergarten students who are eligible for transportation and who have a bus pass will be delivered to the same bus stop they use to board the bus in the mornings on their way to school. Dismissal for secondary students will be at 11 a.m. and the buses will run at 11 a.m. This in-service day gives our employees at the secondary level an opportunity to meet with their new 1997-98 staffs and to make plans for a smooth transition next year for students and staff, Dr. O'Brien stated. She also noted our focus is on creating a positive environment for our youth and helping our students adapt to change. She noted that the staffs at all the six secondary school sites are concentrating their efforts on student activities, course offerings, counseling services, special events, and the many new opportunities for student leadership that will develop as a result of this configuration change. Hitachi is once again going to sponsor a teacher exchange program for three teachers and one administrator in the district. If you are interested in applying, please contact Dr. Nancy O'Brien's office at 366-5852 for an application. The dates for the Norman Hitachi Teacher Exchange Program trip to Japan have been set for July 12th through July 19th. Applications are due back on Wednesday, April 9th in her office. Congratulations to Madison Elementary for meeting the eligibility criteria for the National Title I Distinguished Schools Recognition Program. Madison was selected because it has exceeded adequate yearly progress expectations on both the criteria reference test and the norm reference test. The school has submitted an application as waiting to hear if they will be recognized as a top school in the recognition program. Good luck to Madison. Madison is also very enthusiastic about being selected to be in a TV commercial, which will be filmed by Multimedia and will air nationally. The topic is technology and internet. Plans are underway for two special events coming up. One in April, the Celebration of Teaching Banquet at the Marriott Hotel at the Postal Training Center on Friday, April 18th, and the Service Recognition Event at the Holiday Inn on Monday, May 12th. There is more room this year for the Teacher Banquet than ever before. Tickets are available at the Professional Development Center. We will be in a new facility at the Marriott. The Teachers of the Year will be honored and the District Teacher of the Year will be named. During our recognition event, we will honor our employees who are retiring from the district and the employees who have served 15, 20, 25, 30, or more years with the district. For Norman Public Schools, I'm Connie Blaney.
Thank you, Mrs. Blaney. New to our show is Dr. John Clinton, the Director of Fine Arts for the Norman Public Schools. Today, Dr. Clinton is joined by Jim Myler and Dennis Smith as they discuss how to deal with the band issues when the high school split this fall.
Welcome to Focus on the Fine Arts. I'm John Clinton, Director of Fine Arts, and we're pleased to have you here for this show. We have two guests with us who are very important guests to the Norman Public Schools. They've been with us for many years. This is Jim Myler, who is currently the Director of Instrumental Music at West Mid High School. This is Dennis Smith, who is currently the Director of Instrumental Music at Central Mid High School and also coordinator of the band program. Welcome to both of you.
Thank you. Glad to
have you here. Well, we're in for some big changes next year. Have lots going on. We're switching, as everyone knows, we're switching to two high schools, 9 through 12, and these are two of the people who will be working with the band and the orchestras, as well as Gene Statham will be working with the orchestras as well. And these are the two people who are going to be responsible for all of that and what's going to be going on with that. Jim, tell me how you're feeling about this change.
Excited.
Yes?
Very excited about the whole possibility of a four-year school and the chance to work with the older students on a regular basis.
Yes.
And Dennis and Gene, and I think we've got a good team here. We're really looking forward to it.
I think it's going to be great. Dennis, what are your feelings?
Well, it's a great opportunity. As long as I've been in the district, I've felt that a four-year program was one of the things that would help us the most with our older kids. And having two-year schools has been fine, but it has presented some unique problems for us in retention and instrumentation, among other things, in our groups. And I think with the four-year program, as it evolves over the next few years, I think we're going to see some significant improvements and in our total program, and I think it's going to be a lot easier for us to work with as a staff.
Good. What kind of improvement comes in the performance of the students with a four-year school?
Continuity of instruction, for one thing. I think that that's the main thing that we can improve on. We'll have the kids in our classes every day for 4 years if they stay with our program. And that kind of instruction and that kind of progress with each student is critical, I think, to overall musical success.
Well, there's lots of complicated things that are involved in this whole process of changing from two-year schools, actually 3 2-year high schools, to 2 4-year high schools. What kind of questions have you had, Jim, that have laid on your mind for all of these several months that we've gone through this process?
We've been working on this one for what, 3 or 4 years now, as the band staff has talked about this for a long time, and we've got any dozen questions that you could come up with, things like, how are we going to split the kids, because we'll have 150 to 200 or more in each school in the band program. How are we going to split those kids? We've decided at this moment on 9th grade band and then a 10 through 12 group, but will we have too many students in 10 through 12 for one band? Mm-hmm. Will we need two? How are we going to do all city? Are we going to have one jazz band or two? Who's going to teach them? I think that's the questions that we have at this moment, is what are we going to teach? We find there's more classes than there are people.
Yes.
So there's still a lot of questions up in the air.
It's a difficult situation. Have you discussed and been involved with what's going to happen with marching band, Dennis?
I think working with Brad Benson and David Davison and yourself, the five of us have met frequently, and we've discussed it just probably from about every angle you can.
Yes.
We have decided that to keep the ninth graders in a more or less technical training situation on the inside basis, but maybe have them do some exposure to marching in the fall, perhaps performing at the homecoming game with the older kids, and perhaps doing a parade or two in the community, such as the Christmas parade. For the 10th, 11th, and 12th, we've decided to have them march together during the football season and keep them all together. And there's been some preliminary discussions for this first year, when there's only one football team, that we would actually have the North Band and the high school band perform together as a large group at each home football game for the first year. And then when there are actually two separate football teams in 1998, I guess, then we would probably have two separate entities as far as marching bands go.
Yeah, that's going to be a huge marching band, because you're talking about how many, for example, at each one of the schools, do you have an estimate about how many students will be 10 through 12?
Norman High, we're thinking somewhere around 100, or maybe just a little bit more. Norman North is
about 120,
about
110, something like that.
So you're going to have over 200 students out on the marching field.
At least.
Now, there's something to think about in the future for this that just popped into my mind. One is that, remember when we switched from a 10 through 12 school to 11 and 12 marching band, all the questions that we received about what happened to all the kids in the band? Do you think that we're going to run into that same problem when we go from two schools, 10 through 12, to separate schools, 10 through 12? What do you think the response will be?
I'm sure some people will wonder what happened.
Yes.
The philosophy for what we're doing next year is probably based on the single football team aspect more than any other thing. And I think the community will understand what we're doing. Mm-hmm. When there's two football teams, it makes sense to go ahead and split and be two separate high school bands. I think that's what everyone would expect. But when there's one football team this first year, it makes sense to stay together. On a second count, we thought about what it does to our senior class next year. And it's a difficult thing for the seniors to split up for that last year of school, and in every aspect of the school community, but especially in band. And marching together and performing at the games together each Friday night that we have them, I think that's a neat thing to keep the seniors together for this first year of the split and let them participate in that activity. I think it'll mean a much more special senior year for them than it would have been normally.
It'll be pretty special in the fact that they'll be in this huge band that's fundamentally going to cover the football field. I mean, that's going to be a lot of sound coming out of that.
We've done that when we've had the West and Central football games, where we've had both our bands on the field. So they've experienced something like that. And when we did the homecoming game here, we've all gotten together. So we've had, 300 last year on the field.
That's great.
So it's a big group.
You were talking about that you've really been in the planning of this for 3 or 4 years. It hadn't just happened overnight. One of the things that people may not appreciate or understand is how much planning marching band, for example, takes. Now that you're going to be doing one show between the two schools, you've got to look at music, you've got to look at the drill itself. What are the kind of things have to be logistically worked out in
drum
order for
majors.
This to function?
Drum majors? Who's going to be drum major? What is the function of drum major going to be?
Yes.
Who's going to take charge of writing the show, getting music picked out, arranged, if we want to do that, if we want to do something special? All the little things, like, do we have enough ladders for the conductors? Do we have a big ladder so that we can watch the kids from 20 feet up here at Norman High, or do they have one at North? Mm-hmm. Do we have a podium for the lead conductor?
Yes. When are we going to rehearse and put this together?
Where are we going to rehearse?
Yes. And so the things Jim and I have dealt with putting our mid-highs together some in the fall, we're used to dealing with this in many aspects, but this is even larger.
Yes.
In that We have the older kids, and it's, I think, a more major musical event. I mean, right. It's harder.
Plus, there's we would expect that a high school band is going to do more mm-hmm. on a football field than what we've been doing. And we've gotten the kids out, and we've done a very limited beginning introduction to marching. We expect quite a bit more.
That's
at
right.
this point.
And the community expects more mm-hmm. from that. They have learned to become entertained by marching bands, and it is a difficult situation to be involved in. Well, there's several things, not only the marching band, but let's talk about there's All City, there's a performing arts center that we have eventually maybe going to come about for us. We have concert bands, uniforms for all of that. But if you don't mind, let's stick just a minute on marching band, because that's a major topic for most of the people in our community. Tell me about what you have done. Now, you're going to be at Norman High School, at the present high school. What have you done in terms of marching band uniforms, for example, in order to get things planned for next year? What's had to be done?
We keep the same uniform, of mm-hmm. course. We've got more students, and you know, looking to the future, we're expecting the program to be growing. And we've got some new uniforms ordered so that we'll be able to fit everybody. Norman High North we've met as a committee and redesigned a uniform. So we've got, and that's been ordered, mm-hmm. in my
yes.
understanding anyway, so that everybody, at least 10 through 12, assuming you know everything goes right and delivery's on time, we should have uniforms for everybody on the field.
Great. And Dennis, you've been through uniform purchases at least once in your lifetime.
Yes.
What do you anticipate happening? He was just mentioning about the uniform, if they all come in on time. How long a process are we talking about here?
Well, it's my understanding, or you're looking at a minimum of 6 months from the time that you actually award a bid and then receive the uniforms. They're made, shipped, inspected, and you're looking at 6 months. Now, prior to that, you still have to have a design process, and then you have to submit bids to companies and let them have a chance to respond, and then you have to decide who gets the bid and award that, and then you have the 6 months. So it's a time-consuming process. And we started it fairly early, but we're still going to be pushing the deadline to have them here on time. So we've had to think about some alternative things that we might need to wear at first to get started if the uniforms should not arrive on time. Mm-hmm. But you know, we're keeping our fingers crossed that there will be here and that we can all wear our new uniforms together. It's a very expensive process, but it's very expensive as far as time is concerned, too. You just don't do it in a few weeks.
No, it takes a long time. I agree with that. I really appreciate both of you being here as part of this. And like I said earlier, we have a number of topics that we need to discuss, of which probably can't be in two shows. But if you don't mind, I'd like to invite you back next week, and we'd like to talk about the All City concert, like the concert performance. I'd like to talk about the eventuality of a performing arts center for us and what that would mean to you and how that would affect our students. So, Jim and Dennis, thank you very much for being with us, and I look forward to seeing you again next week. And thank you for being with us as we focus on the fine arts.
Thank you, Dr. Clinton. Well, with the band changes in full swing, this will probably be the last time that the combined 9th and 10th grade bands will perform in All City. They are directed by Dr. Clinton's guest, Jim Myler.
Combined mid-high school bands. The two directors for this are Dennis Smith, who's currently at Central Mid High School. He will be one of the conductors at Norman High School. And the gentleman who is conducting this evening, Mr. Jim Myler, is currently at West and will be one of the conductors at Norman High School as well. Would you please welcome with me for the final performance in the All City Concert, the combined mid high school bands.
What a truly amazing performance. Thanks, guys. Well, that's all the time we have for this edition of District Directions. Until then, I'm Amanda Patterson.